you have some questions.
Brad, can you just comment on the three guys in your group who were voted team captains earlier this week?
Obviously, you know, you start with Square, and, you know, you think about it, Square, and it's four, right? You know, you got Square, you got Jaquez, you got Jordan Wright and J.J. Weaver. All four of those guys are guys that our team follows. It's why on a team-wide vote, those guys got picked, because they know how to go about it. They come in the building, they put their work in. They're demanding of their teammates, but at the same time, they're there to bring them along. You know, if they have questions, they're the ones in meeting rooms trying to help them. Out on the field, you see those guys trying to coach them up, you know, and I think everybody sees it, everybody feels it. You know, they each sort of bring their own unique style. And that's what's fun. I mean, that's a big deal to have four guys on defense. And, you know, all at that, you talk about all at that level right there, and you're talking about all at that linebacker level.
You heard it goes freshman and outside linebacker progress over camp. It seems like those guys are going to have to play, especially this week.
Yeah, every year we talk about, you know, outside linebackers that come in and they're dealing with their first year, right? What have I always said? It's hard. There's a lot going on. You know, they've got to do, you know, three different things. You know, they got to be edge setters in the run game. They've got to be able to pass rush, right? They got to be able to cover and then drop. And so we ask those things. Those guys have a lot going on. So they've made definitive progress, and we're going to need them to continue. And so they're each going to have to sort of find, what they can do. I've got to find what they can do best and try to put them in those situations, because obviously, you know, we're going to need them at that position. We've got two old guys and three young guys. Now you throw in, having guys like Alex Afari out there. But again, what's he?
I'll point the ball!
So we're going to be young at times, but they got to learn.
What is it with Andrew Phillips that made you all think he could be a successful player for you at nickel?
Well, he's got quick twitch, inside burst. Andrew's done a great job from that nickel spot, you know, and he's got really good ball skills, good feel, instinct. But especially when you slide in and play nickel, you know, out on the edges, you can be a little bit longer. Even if you're a step behind, your length helps you. Once you get inside and you go against quicker slots, option routes, you've got to be able to redirect, explode. And he's got those quick twitch traits that you're looking for. And he's really got a good knack for the football. Has made a lot of plays on the ball this fall, and we're going to need him to do that on Saturday throughout the whole year.
Brad, this kind of ties into the first question about the captains, but you've got those two inside backers who played almost 100 college games. Now, what does it mean to you and what you were able to call defensively to have two guys in there who've seen so many plays?
Yeah, you know what? I can make tweaks, and I feel comfortable in terms of being able to have sort of extensions of me out on the field, and they can help guys get lined up. They can I know they're going to make the right calls, the right adjustments. But it's that same, it's not about how much I know. It's not about how much they know. You know, all 11 guys on the field have to understand. So I can't just, throw too much out there, because while those two might be able to comprehend and understand what I'm trying to get done, it doesn't mean that, those younger guys that are playing actually understand. So I have to be aware of how much we can do in that regard. But I feel comfortable in terms of being able to talk to them, ask them what's going on in front of them. Hey, did you see this? Did you see that? And if something's confusing to them, then I know it's probably confusing to everybody, and I better.
Marcus really praised Kerry for the steps he's taken over this offseason. What have you seen from him that makes you all so confident in how he's playing?
Well, he's put a lot of time in the weight room. think he's stronger in his lower half, so he's stronger at the top of routes. He's worked a lot on his, you know, on his ball skills, ball production, does a lot, you know, extra, you know, from jugs machines. And, you know, he's up early, you know, into the film room. And I was just talking about him today. You know, he read a route concept really well. And I was just joking with him. I said, oh, I guess somebody's been watching film, right? And those are the kind of plays that you need, you know. We talk about stealing a play or two a game that could be the difference. And it could be by split. It could be, you know, by down and distance. It could be something that just gives you a quick tell that allows you to make a, you know, gain a step. And it could be a PBU, it could be a pick, it could be something that changes the game. If every guy can steal a play or two, you think about over the course of the game, you know, that's going to bode well for us.
Brad, when you turn on the tape, what makes Brett Gabbert a successful quarterback, and what kind of challenges can he bring your defense?
Ball placement. I think he's really savvy. He throws a really catchable deep ball. I think he doesn't get rattled. He's a uber competitor in that regard. Been playing, you know, since essentially his freshman year. Went in, you watch him play at Iowa game one in that kind of environment at night as a true freshman and not be rattled. So you know the kid's a gamer. And so we know we've got a challenge on our hand in that regard.
Coach, we saw so many flashes from JJ in the past, and this year he gets voted as a captain and he's finally healthy. How important is he to what you want to do with this defense this year?
Yeah, I think they're all important, you know. JJ no more than the others, but obviously we need him to be a difference maker. You play that jack position, that position's got a chance to change the game. When you're a pass rusher, you know, you can make up for a lot of ills if you can get the quarterback. If you're an edge setter, you can make run games a lot easier if you can set, you know, a dynamic edge, you know. And so we need him to be that kind of player that changes the game. You need him to change the map, you know, and whether that's taking on to a puller and knocking off the second one, and so now we're playing 11 on 10. You know, he's got to do some of those. He's got to have some of those plays. He doesn't have to do more, you know, than's required, but he's got to do his our job plus, you know, just a little bit more than just your job.
Brad, you talked about communication being a big factor especially with the safeties on the back end. How are those guys adjusting, you know, in their new roles and having some new guys back there?
You know what? I think it's been really nice to have a steady force like Ty, who's been in this system for, you know, as long as he has, and he's come back for essentially his sixth year because of the COVID year. He's like the linebacker level. Like, he understands what I'm trying to get done, you know, and, you know, from a secondary adjustment standpoint, that's huge. Those guys, those safeties have to handle all those checks and adjustments. Obviously, Jalen's played, significant snaps for us in the past, but, you know, he's moving from strong to free, and so there's a transition piece in there. And so to have a guy like Ty that can just sort of, there's a calm to him right now, and then you add in two young guys like Jordan Lovett and Zion in the mix, and you know, now you've got two older guys that are sort of bringing those younger guys along, and you know, I think we're going to be in decent shape. But that communication is so big, and you know, when it's third down and the crowd's loud, or they're going to need to be able to get all the checks communicated.
Brad, you talked at the beginning of camp about trying to get pass defense back to what it was the year before last. You said we got a lot of work to do. How do you feel about where you are right now relative to, you know, late August or late September compared to where you want to be?
Yeah, I think we're, I think Coach has said it too. I think we're further along this year than maybe we've been in the past in that regard. So much of that, you know, it's coverage, it's pass rush, it all works together. So I don't know until we see what Saturday brings. I feel comfortable with where we are, but we'll find out who we are here in a couple of days. But yeah, it's pretty funny that, you know, and I've talked to our guys about this too, and we know we need to be better than where we were last year. People forget we actually gave up fewer passing yards per game last year than we did. Now, COVID was a different style year, but they still take that. Those guys have taken that personal, and not just on the back. It's across the board. Like they want to be considered a top-notch defense, and they know they have to earn it in every game, in every category. And so we're not in any mindset of relinquishing where we were against the run. We took a big step forward last year in rushing defense, and we want to stay that way, and we want to get back to being in the top, in our conference in pass defense. And if you can do that in both categories, it'll make you a good total defense. But at the end of the day, the only stat that matters is points. It doesn't matter. If you told me that we'd give up 900 yards and let up 0 points, I would take it every day of the week. Every day of the week, as opposed to giving up 30 points and 250 total yards. So if we can keep them off the scoreboard, we give our team a chance to win.
Okay, Brent, thank you.
Thank you.
I got a line I need to.